Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Maldives police arrest serving ministers for alleged sorcery on Thursday. Pakistan passes tax rate in Bangladesh. And traffic snarls threw daily life out of gear in India's national capital. A portion of the canopy at the departure area of Terminal 1 collapsed, officials said, which killed one person and injured 8 people. Around 10 flights were cancelled and 40 were delayed as flight operations were diverted to other terminals amid the rescue work. The civil aviation minister said an inquiry has been ordered into the collapse.
The situation is under control. The whole rest of the terminal building has been closed off and everything is being thoroughly inspected so that any other untoward incident does not happen here.
The fresh spell of heavy rainfall submerged several parts of Delhi and caused huge traffic snarls and accidents in some areas. Large parts of colonies were also waterlogged, with knee-deep water making it difficult for residents and daily commuters. The city of 20 million people received nearly 228 millimeters rainfall at its main Safdarjung weather station in the 24 hours, ending 8:30 a.m., a 266% departure from normal.
जो मेरा रास्ता मेरे को करोलबाग जाना होता है, जो पौन घंटे का रास्ता, अभी मेरे को पौने दो घंटे हो गए हैं और ट्रैफिक पूरे रास्ते में ट्रैफिक का बुरा हाल है. पानी जगह जगह पानी भरा हुआ है रास्ते में. गाड़ियां लोगों की खराब हो रही है, बस खराब हो रही है, बाइकें खराब हो रही है, ऑटो खराब हो रही है.
The Maldives police on Thursday arrested two serving ministers for allegedly performing black magic on President Mohamed Muizu, reports have suggested. Shamnaz Salim, who was a state minister at the Environment Ministry, her ex-husband Adam Ramiz, who was serving as a minister at the President's office, and two others were arrested in the case, and both Shamnaz and Ramiz have worked with Muizu as members of the Male City Council when he was serving as the city's mayor. Notably, the Maldives government has yet to make an official statement on the matter. Sorcery is not a criminal offence in Maldives, but under Islamic law, it does carry a 6-month jail sentence. People across the island nation practice traditional ceremonies, believing they can win favours and curse opponents. And while the Pakistan government has decided to reduce tax exemptions in its annual budget and widen tax base, traders and experts have expressed the new reforms are only adding to financial burden of the people. A report.
Pakistan's parliament on Friday passed the government's tax-heavy financial bill for the coming fiscal year ahead of more talks of a new IMF bailout. But experts have condemned the flawed tax system, which is creating a major divide and adding to people's financial burden. Crisis at Pakistan faces a persistent challenge of maintaining a low tax-to-GDP ratio, and the budget has set a challenging target of Rs. 13 trillion tax collection. The complicated tax structure imposes a heavy compliance burden on businesses and individuals.
Agar tankhwah mein 20 ya 25 ya 30% izafa hua hai, to mehngai mein 200-300% izafa hua hai. Gareeb aadmi jo hai, wo satah-e-ghurbat se mazid niche chala gaya hai. एक मिडल जो औसत दर्जे के लोग होते थे, जो न बहुत अमीर होते थे न बहुत गरीब होते थे, वो तो ख़त्म हो गए हैं. या तो इस मुल्क में बहुत अमीर लोग रहते हैं या इस मुल्क में गरीब लोग रहते हैं.
पाकिस्तान इज इन टॉक्स विद द IMF फॉर अ लोन ऑफ 6 to 8 billion US dollars एज इट सीक्स टू अवर्ट अ डिफॉल्ट फॉर एन इकॉनमी ग्रोइंग एट द स्लोएस्ट पेस इन द रीजन. The rise in the tax target is made up of a 48% increase in direct taxes and 35% hike in indirect taxes. Non-tax revenue, including petroleum levies, is seen as increasing by a whopping 64%.
मैं आप चीज पर टैक्स देते हैं, हम बिजली पर टैक्स देते हैं, पानी पर टैक्स देते हैं, चाय की पत्ती पर टैक्स देते हैं, माचिस पर टैक्स देते हैं, गैस पर टैक्स देते हैं, चूल्हे पर टैक्स देते हैं, भगोने पर टैक्स देते हैं और दूध पर टैक्स देते हैं, और उसके बाद हम हुकूमत ये कहती है कि कोई टैक्स नहीं दे रहा। अरे भाई, हम 15 जगह पर टैक्स दे रहे हैं, उसके बावजूद हमें नॉन फाइलर कह रहे हैं। नॉन फाइलर की इस्तलाह जो है ये पढ़े लिखे लोगों की वेशदवानी है। हुकूमत टैक्स का बेहतरीन निज़ाम वज़ा करें कि जो मौजूदा टैक्स का निज़ाम है ये फरसूदा निज़ाम है, इससे गरीब और अमीर के दरमियान दूरियां पैदा हो रही हैं।
Amid a surge in terror incidents which Pakistan blames on the banned Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan or TTP, Defence Minister Khwaja Asif on Thursday hinted at the possibility of cross-border strikes in Afghanistan to eliminate militant hideouts in the neighbouring country. Speaking during an interview, Asif said Islamabad could strike terror havens in Afghanistan and it would not be against international law since Kabul had been exporting terrorism to Pakistan. The minister also ruled out any chances of dialogue with the banned outfit, saying that there was no common ground. Relations between Kabul and Islamabad have nosedived in recent months, with Pakistan accusing Afghanistan of providing safe haven to TTP militants to hide and conduct attacks on Pakistan. Meanwhile, a photo exhibition on the sidelines of the UN session in Geneva is showcasing the rapid and inclusive development in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Take a look.
In a significant display of progress and development initiatives, a banner exhibition highlighting advancements in India's Jammu and Kashmir was held on Friday outside the UN office in Geneva. Organized by Sheikh Khalid, a Kashmiri author and peace activist, along with rights defender Elena Velejo, the exhibition featured a series of posters illustrating various technological interventions and advancements, especially under the Srinagar Smart City Initiative. It highlighted the strides made in tourism, education and environmental conservation efforts, particularly highlighting the ongoing efforts to rejuvenate the Dal Lake. He expressed satisfaction with the current government's efforts in combating cross-border terrorism from Pakistan effectively and remarked the exhibition also aimed to counter extremist ideologies.
The Kashmiris have taken the path ahead with positivity. I think that's why I'm here to showcase to the international community that Kashmir is safe. Please do visit Kashmir, spread the word of positiveness. We have a challenge of counter-terrorism originating from Pakistan, but still the Kashmiris have taken the pledge that their future is safe in India.
And as Taliban regime is preparing for the upcoming UN-led Doha meeting in Qatar, human rights activists have condemned the move to keep Afghan women out of the meet. Afghan women's rights advocate Zubeda Akbar said she had declined an invitation by the UN to attend the meeting as women have been excluded from the main tables of discussion. She expressed her frustration in a post on X, stating that Afghan women deserve to be shaping the agenda at the meet, and highlighted the severe crisis faced by women and girls in Afghanistan. Other prominent Afghan women also expressed disappointment over the UN's apparent appeasement of Taliban demands. The third round of the Doha meeting is scheduled for 30th June to July 1st. The UN will host discussions between special envoys and representatives of women and civil society on 2nd of July. Moving on. Lawmakers from the opposition Nepali Congress have warned PM Dehal-led government against taking loans from the China's Belt and Road Initiative and stressed it must forge a national consensus before proceeding further. Speaking during Thursday's parliamentary meeting, former Foreign Minister Narayan Prakash South suggested the government should accept the grants only in line with the provisions with other countries, as it could be a trap. This comes after Prime Minister Dehal informed the parliament that the government intends to take loans, promising they won't exceed interest rates above 1.5%. Nepal and China signed a Memorandum of Understanding on the bilateral cooperation under the BRI framework in 2017, but the copy of it is not available in the public domain. The opposition also raised questions over this and demanded the copy of the agreement should be made public. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.